Welcome to the Hollywood Scholar. I'm Jed Morgan, and the closer and closer we get to the 60th anniversary of Doctor Who and the release of the 14th Doctor, Ncuti and David Tennant's return, and the inclusion of Neil Patrick Harris into Doctor Who universe, the more I get concerned, because the more news we hear about it, the more concerning it gets. Now, this article actually contains a few positive things when it comes to an interview from Neil Patrick Harris, but it also contains a very concerning statement from Neil Patrick Harris. Now, abandoning the comments really condensed it right here in their headline. Doctor Who actor Neil Patrick Harris says Ncuti will portray franchise's first gay doctor. And now, a lot of the fan base really prefers the doctor to be asexual by choice, not like actually asexual. It's just he realizes the damages that happens to people when he interacts with them on a romantic level, so he chooses not to. And I firmly believe that that should be the case, with a very, very few exceptions. And being gay or whatever should not be the defining feature of a doctor. Being straight shouldn't be a defining feature of the doctor. It's not like, David Tennant, he was the straightest doctor, we're going to remember him as the straight doctor. No, when you're marketing a movie like this, when you're reading a script and getting the essence of the doctor, like Neil Patrick Harris is talking about here, I want something better. Like Christopher Eccleston, he was the warrior doctor. He was the one who had just committed the genocide of the Time War. He was tortured. He was trying to atone for his sins. Describe it like that. Say like, hey, this is the first tortured doctor. Or David Tennant, he's the hero doctor. He's the one who gets the girl. He's the one who's suave and sassy. Describe it like that. I want, when someone reads a Doctor Who script, to bring out conclusions like that. Now, oh, he's super gay. The most defining attribute of this new doctor is he loves cock. He just loves that cock. I don't want that, or even vagina, to be the defining feature of the doctor. Why should that be the thing that describes this newest iteration of the Doctor the most? That really bothers me, and that implies that Russell T. Davies is really, really focusing on that in the scripts, the marketing, and his conversations with Neil Patrick Harris. So that very, very much concerns me, and Ncuti definitely seems like that's his primary motivation, is to be the first gay Doctor, and that's very concerning. I was okay initially with the announcement of Ncuti Gatwa. I'm a little worried that he won't have the gravitas to really portray the role, but the more we hear about his portrayal of it, how Russell's writing him, how people interact with him, the more I'm concerned, because they seem to be focusing more on the diversity of Ncuti rather than the character that he's going to be portraying. And that's very much something I am against. If he just happened to be a new doctor and it was just, hey, I'm going to do my best job, I can't judge anyone untoward for something like that. That is how it should be approached. And if the guy happens to be black, the guy happens to be gay, sure, go for it. As long as he's good for the part when it comes to the doctor, totally okay with that. But from what we hear, he's the gay doctor. That's what's defining about him. I do want to get into a little bit of Neil Patrick Harris's comments here, and some of them are all right. Like, he's like, hey, Russell hit me up, text me, and gave me a delicious script and whatnot, and it was fine. Nothing really wrong there. And I do actually want to point out, this is some of the positive news that I heard from Neil Patrick Harris specifically, something that Jodie Whittaker specifically did not do. So he's saying that he wasn't familiar with Doctor Who before taking on this role. He knew it in a Comic-Con-y way, he says here. It's a British thing. He'd never watched the show. But because of his involvement in the franchise, he decided to apply himself into homework, researching the mythos of Doctor Who and getting a feel for the new actor to portray the hero. The world is interesting, he asserted. I got to study and learn about it. And Ncuti, who's becoming the new Doctor, I got to meet and interact with him a bit. That is actually good. I love it when actors are like, hey, I didn't know anything about this universe, but I applied myself, I researched it, I wanted to know, understand this world. Very similar to how Matt Smith did it when he took on the role. He wasn't familiar with the show, but he made himself familiar. That is not the case for Jodie Whittaker. She said she was too important. She was too special to interact or research the previous Doctor. She never watched anyone's series besides her own. She's admitted that. That's very concerning. So Neil Patrick Harris's comments here are good, and it actually does imply that he's interacting with Ncuti as the Doctor. So that third special that Neil Patrick Harris and David Tennant are a part of, it seems like Ncuti will also be participating in that, despite not seeing them behind the scenes. And it seems like they've wrapped filming. That's another piece of information from this interview with the Variety that he added, that they finished filming. But this is when things get concerning. It was then that Harris dropped a relevant tidbit of information, exclaiming he's glorious and he'll be the first gay Doctor, which is super, super cool. So it'll be a sexier Doctor, he concluded, and I'm excited. Now, I don't necessarily agree with anything that he just said there. The Doctor, I don't really want him to be sexy. He's supposed to be really awkward and out of his time, and sometimes suave in like an old-timey way. A lot of Doctors were really good at that. The majority of them were really good at being unintentionally sexy. So being sexy or who is not something that I'm really attracted to. And just a lot of that is wrong. He should not be, oh, he's the first gay doctor. That is not something that I want to hear. If it's just that he's the first gay actor, so what? Sure, that's totally fine. But it's like, this doctor, he's uber, uber gay. This doctor, he loves to suck cock. It's like, no, tell me something about his character, his motivation, the type of person he's going to be, because every doctor is a little bit different. I want to know, is he a wise old man trapped in a young man's body again? Is he focused, driven by curiosity? What? I want more than, oh, he wants cock. He just wants cock. And yeah, it seems to be very much the gay era of Doctor Who, with the inclusion of Yasmin Finney as well, and a lot of gay actors, which in and of itself isn't a bad thing, but it's their hyper-emphasis on it that is the problem. If it's just like, yeah, a lot of the actors we hired happen to be gay, we include occasional gay storyline, not a big deal. Not a big deal whatsoever, but it's like, this is the first gay doctor, and this is the first trans companion, and this is the first gay villain, and we're just like so awesome because it's all gaysies. It's like, no, tell me about the story. Entice the fans back with the ideas that you have, the story and plot that you have, not the diversity checkboxes that you check. And so a lot of this news is very concerning to me. Neil Patrick Harris, it was a bit of a whiplash in that interview that he had. I love that he said he went into the research. That is very unusual these days. And I don't know if Shudigatwa is doing his research like he should be, just like Neil Patrick Harris. But I'd be interested to hear about that if he's going to. But overall, a negative article here and a negative interview, because I don't want to hear that he's defined as being gay. I don't want to hear that he's defined as being straight. I want to hear what motivates his individual decisions. Is he the warrior? Is he the hero? Is he the runner? Stuff like that. I want to see and hear in a marketing campaign for Doctor Who. Not he loves cock. That is not what I want to hear. But anyway, that's all I have for today. I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments below. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Anon. If you like what I do here and want to see good, compelling stories that Hollywood will no longer give you, check out my book series, Odyssey of a Phoenix, a mythological epic about philosophy, morality, and modern-day mental illness issues. Books 1, Down in Flames, and Book 2, Apocalypse Then, currently on sale. Book 3, Kill the Dark, coming soon.